Hey friends, today's a pretty exciting day because Visual Studio 2017 version 15.6 is out. And along with that, there's a ton of new Xamarin goodness. My name is Matt Sokup, and I'm a senior cloud developer advocate here at Microsoft, and I'm gonna be your tour guide as we go and explore some of the new features with it. There's a lot of iOS goodness that was put in with this new version. And some of the new features are the ability to have VS on your Windows machine update everything over on the Mac. So no longer do you have to hop between Windows and your Mac to keep the versions of Xamarin up to date. It's going to be done for you automatically. And that's pretty slick. Another thing that's really cool is automatic iOS Wi-Fi debugging on device. Those are a lot of words. But what it means is that you now can, over on the Windows side, debug over Wi-Fi on your iPhone or iPad. And the way you do this is that you go through and you pretty much just do a check mark over on Xcode. And then over on the VS side, you just select your iPhone device and here it shows up. You're connected via network and you can just deploy it that way. That's pretty slick. And then one of the biggest features released is the ability to have Visual Studio Community Edition now to run the remoted simulators. So now VS Community is up to par with the other versions of Visual Studio Professional and Enterprise and the ability to run the remoted simulators within VS. As we can see, we have it up and starting, and now we have the Visual Simulator remoted over to the Mac and updated. Sweet. So what does this app do? Another thing that's really cool about VS over on Windows is that we can run core ML models. So what does this mean? A cool offering that Microsoft has is called the Custom Vision AI service. And what this allows us to do is to take a bunch of images and train a model to recognize things in that image. So what I did is I uploaded a bunch of photos of flowers that I found on the internet. And then I trained it to recognize things such as tulips or daffodils in those flowers because it's springtime. So once I have those recognized, I train it. And then I can go and export those either to Core ML or to TensorFlow. Because we're talking about iOS today, I'm going to do Core ML. So once I get it downloaded, all I need to do is add that Core ML model. It's going to come down as an ML model into my resources. Make sure I set it as bundling. And then just using the regular iOS syntax, get URL, then ML model, compile model, and so on. I can, and this is all in VS Community Edition, pick a photo and have the simulator recognize that that photo is a crocus. So that's pretty neat. So VS 2017 version 15.6 introduces several great new features. The ability to keep your Mac up to date from VS 2017, the ability to Wi-Fi debug on device, remoted simulator for the community edition, and a neat feature where you can include Core ML, machine learning, all done from Windows on Visual Studio. Until VS 2017 version 15.7, I'm Matt Sokup.